You all right? Right, you wait here. I'll go ahead.
Is she an old lady?
No, she's younger than me, just. I haven't seen nothing of her for 3 days. Mind you, I was at my son's day before yesterday, but last night was our bingo night. She never misses her bingo.
Are you close friends?
Yes.
I can do that, this kind of excitement.
Tell you me. Mind you, it was all go here a few days ago.
Was it?
Well, we had police all over the place.
Why's that?
They're not supposed to park on the pavement, you see. You can't get past. All the officers were taking details down for 2 days. Marie, Mrs. Austin, she was full of it. She's always writing letters to the council. I do hope she's all right. She's not a well woman as it is.
Oh?
She's epileptic, you see, and terrible eczema. Bathroom cabinets full of pills and potions.
Debbie?
Where are you going, Mrs. Hamilton? Sarge?
I found her. We need information on the GP and the next of kin.
Mrs. Hamilton, I'm sorry.
Oh, no.
Dear diary.
Would you mind?
Doesn't say that, does it?
Why does nobody fancy me?
Look, it's my record of workbook, that's all. I'm just putting in some details of a stuff I did this morning.
So is this like a hobby that you've got, is it, Reg?
No, I'm just covering my back, that's all.
Covering your back? What for?
Well, because you never know. Come the day, only the efficient will survive.
And you're efficient, are you, Reg?
Well, I'm charging me.
Yeah, but a list of parking tickets, cautions and horties isn't going to impress anyone, is it, Reg?
Well, I'm not out to impress, just trying to do my job.
Oh, really?
Compare my book with his, then you'll see who's the most efficient.
Well, that sounds like a good idea to me, Tony. I can feel the money burning a hole in my pocket already.
What do you mean?
Yeah. Might be worth a little wager.
Huh. Oh, no, hang on. Look, I'm just trying to make a point.
Who's the most efficient? Reg or you?
Do you know Mrs. Austin well?
She was a patient of mine for years. Quite a formidable woman.
Have you seen her recently?
No. Epilepsy isn't the problem. It used to be. The drugs we prescribe these days keep the condition in check. I'd only see her every now and then for a repeat prescription.
So do you think she could have had a fit and drowned?
Couldn't say for sure. You'll have to wait for the coroner. But I'd be surprised if it was down to a seizure.
Why?
Well, there'd be no reason for her to have a fit unless she became careless about her routine, and that wasn't in Marie's makeup.
Routine?
Well, she was on anticonvulsants. One in the morning, one early evening. But if she missed a dosage, it could trigger off a seizure.
Carbamazepine?
They're the ones.
Well, could she have committed suicide? Oh, indeed.
I very much doubt it. She was a practicing Catholic, quite old-fashioned in that respect.
Well, they're the only tablets we've found, as you can see. The cabinet's empty.
Hang on. These aren't carbamazepine. They're aspirin. And they look very similar, but these are definitely aspirin.
Right, what about next of kin? You mentioned a son, Philip?
They've not been seeing eye to eye recently.
Why is that?
Oh, they had a big bust-up over the Matkins girl. She didn't want them to get married. Not good enough. But they did. And now they're not speaking.
Do you have an address for him?
Oh, it'll be next door somewhere.
Debbie, can you get on to CID? I want to treat this as a suspicious.
Right. So that's 1 point for a stop and search, 2 for any tickets issued, 0.5 for a haughty, 3 for an arrest, 5 points for a good arrest, and all points and protocols in between.
Can't it just be 3 points for an arrest and that's it?
Okay. Information leading to an arrest or assisting in arrest counts at 0.5, depending on the offence. And whatever you write in your record of workbooks can and will be used as evidence against you.
You are beginning to lose it, Bob.
I just thought you'd be interested.
Not me, I was just passing. This is Jim Shell.
Oh, thanks.
I mean, what have you got? Old Marie Austin there. Not quite past her sell-by date, but certainly reduced for a quick sale. Has a fit and drowns in a bath. Simple enough, but not for you.
I admit it looks like natural causes.
Looks like? The place is cleaner than a nun's laundry basket. No marks, no stains, nothing.
Well, where's the motive? Where's the crime?
Yeah.
That's my point. It's too clean. Marie Austin, she's got epilepsy, eczema. Now, that cabinet in her bathroom should be full of pills and potions. And what do we find? Aspirin. in a carbamazepine bottle.
Well, maybe she got cured.
But what about suicide?
Yeah, well, we thought of that. But how do you explain the soap dish still lying across the bath?
My mum's got one just like it, Bob. What's your point?
Look, if someone drowns, you get a lot of thrashing about, right? But the soap dish is still in place. If someone has a seizure, what do?
Throw me washing in?
You'd kick the thing, wouldn't you?
Yeah, well, in my book, a few missing pills and a soap dish do not add up to a crime.
No, but all I'm saying is we ought to treat it as a suspicious.
We're still not interested. Mind you, if you want to take responsibility, I can't stop you.
Philip Austin?
Yes?
May we come in? I'm afraid we've got some bad news for you.
Oh, Polly, got anything for me? What about that sudden death?
What, Harless Road?
Yeah.
No, it's being dealt with.
Well, what number was it?
48. Why?
Well, I was down there the other day, you know, on the parking initiative. I got on very well with a Mrs. Hamilton.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she made a lovely cup of tea, hasn't it? Was there nothing else?
No, it's really quiet.
All right, cheers, Paul. Anything for me, Paul?
When did you last see your mother?
Months ago.
Was that usual? She didn't exactly live far away.
Philip and Maria had a little disagreement.
Mum wasn't too keen on me getting married.
Mothers never are.
Philip thought the world of her, and she of him, but we couldn't talk Maria around. Not even after this.
What was your mother like?
What do you mean?
Was she prone to bouts of depression at all?
Oh, no, she wasn't anything like that, was she, Philip?
No.
No, she was a life and soul.
There's nothing she wouldn't do for you. Great cook. No one could beat her steak and kidney pie.
Oh, I don't know about that, dear. She wasn't exactly the type to forgive and forget either, was she?
She would have come round eventually.
I understand she was epileptic.
Yeah, she was. Should have been there for her, shouldn't have?
What?
Please, this is very distressing for us.
She's done everything for me, everything.
Philip, that's enough. You're embarrassing the officers.
No, really.
There still are some questions.
She drowned, didn't she?
We have to establish the cause of death.
There's no way you're cutting my mother up.
Philip, getting yourself into a state. Why don't you go and put the kettle on?
Oi! It's yours, mate.
It's not mine, mate.
I'll come off it.
It's only a bit of res.
No. You know what this is? 3 points. You're nicked.
How did you meet Philip?
I used to be a secretary at Harker's. Philip was one of the engineers. Still is. I like the way he looked. No, he was too shy to ask me out, so I cornered him at the Christmas party. We were married last summer.
But up until then, he was living with his mother?
Yeah. Sometimes it felt like I was his bit on the side. She was very protective. You said question marks. What exactly?
Oh, it's normal procedure in cases like this. We have to consider all eventualities. Even Marie's mental state.
You think she committed suicide?
Well, we know that Marie was on medication, but all we found was some aspirin in a carbamazepine bottle. And the bathroom cabinet was empty.
Maybe she had a tidy up. Marie was always tidying up.
She was.
It's more than that, Mrs. Austin. The place is almost sterilised.
Well, she was fanatic. She never did anything by halves. It was all or nothing with her.
My mother wouldn't take her own life.
Philip, you don't know that.
I do, and she wouldn't.
I wouldn't put it past her to have done it out of spite.
Well, the post-mortem should tell us more.
Oi, oi, oi. What do you think you're doing?
I'm late.
Well, what's this? This is a pavement.
So what?
Well, so you should be on the road.
Having trouble, Reg?
Need a hand? Possession here, Reg. What you got there?
Stop and search by the look of it. You've got to watch these schoolboys, you know. I mean, he could have a pencil or a ruler or anything on him.
Yeah, very funny, George. Go on, up here.
Didn't seem right someone seeing her like this after last time.
When was that?
I told you ages ago.
What about speaking? Did you call her on the phone? Did she write you a letter?
No, nothing.
No idea about her state of mind.
she loved me, she wouldn't have deserted me.
You weren't speaking.
It's not her fault.
Well, if you weren't speaking, maybe she was depressed.
I'm telling you, she wouldn't have taken her own life.
It's not what Sandra thinks.
Well, she would say that, wouldn't she?
Right, you've said you do not wish to see a solicitor. You can, of course, change your mind at any time.
It's got to be worth at least three, isn't it?
Well, maybe a five, if it's a class A and a few grams over.
It's more than Reggie's got.
What's the betting, sir?
Nick's 4-1 on Sodge.
Hey, look, it's a stray, all right? Found it wandering around by the canal.
Well, don't bring it in here, flea-bitten thing.
Mate, that's 6-1 on.
If I was going to commit suicide, I wouldn't have done it like that.
Or pills?
No, in the bath. I mean, think about it. Marie Austin was a house-proud woman. Well turned out, clean, tidy, never went anywhere without a makeup on. If she was going to take an overdose, don't you think she would have done it fully clothed with a bit of lippy?
Yeah, I see what you mean.
As for suicide, well, Philip seems adamant.
Well, it's either natural causes, manslaughter, or murder. Someone has gone into that house after Maria's died. They've tidied the place up, they've taken all the drugs apart from these, and these they've missed because they were in the dressing gown. It's the only possible explanation.
What about a burglar? Could be a druggie.
That's the wrong type of drugs. Burglars don't tidy up after themselves, do they? Besides, there was no sign of a break-in.
Who'd have had access?
Well, someone she knows. Someone with a key. Philip?
He said he hasn't seen his mother in months.
Maybe he's lying.
Mrs. Hamilton would have seen him. Nothing goes on in that street she doesn't know about.
Unless there was something going on that was more interesting.
Like what?
Well, a clamp down on illegal parking. Reg was on that, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was.
Now, if it had been a pit bull, we might have been able to give you some points.
Yeah, but a mongrel.
Mind you, could have given you a nasty lick.
Oh, very funny, fella, very funny. But the dog was roaming around abandoned, round the streets. Could have caused an accident.
Reg?
Sir?
You were up in Harless Road earlier this week, weren't you?
Yeah, it's part of the new crackdown.
Did you write the registration numbers on your record of workbook?
That's what it's for, Dibs.
You could have a look at it?
Yeah, sure. What's that?
Tough. Yeah, there we go. Will you check those numbers on the PNC, see if any of them are registered in Philip Austin's name? Is that all right, Reg?
Sure.
Anything?
No. Not a Philip Austin in sight.
No points for Reg, then.
No.
That's a pity. I've got a fiver riding on him. Always back the underdog.
Well, nice one, Nick. Possession and a couple of burglaries thrown in.
Yeah? It's got to be a 5-point arrest, then.
Who's your money on, Matt?
That'd be telling. Number two, Jim.
Nick.
Sarge?
Were you involved in that crackdown on the parking in Harless Road?
Yes, Sarge.
Have you got your record of workbook on you?
You never give up, do you, Bob?
Your record of workbook?
Yeah.
Cheers, I'll let you have it back.
Right.
What's all that about? Nick's not the only one trying to score points.
Still nothing.
Right, what's this?
It's a hire vehicle.
Yeah, who's it hired to?
I'll get onto it.
Yeah.
What now?
I've just had a word with the coroner's office. Preliminary indications are that Marie Austin drowned. Also, the levels of carbamazepine are lower than expected.
Hold on a minute. Carbamazo what?
It's an epilepsy-controlling drug.
Well, that's it then, isn't it? Problem solved. She forgot to take her pills.
There were no pills, I told you. We just found some aspirin in a carbamazepine bottle.
So was any aspirin found in the body?
A small amount, but not enough to kill her.
So that rules out suicide, then?
I think someone tampered with her drugs.
You're clutching at straws, Bob.
So how do you explain the missing drugs? The soap dish across the bath. Someone went in after she died, and we've got a good idea who it was.
A hire van was rented out to Harker's Heating Engineers and was illegally parked in Harless Road 2 days ago. The driver was Philip Austin. There's no way he'd have been in the area without going to see her. And by that time, she was already stiff with rigor mortis.
Right. Better get him in, then.
You can't do this. He's done nothing. Nothing.
Mrs. Austin, your husband is coming to the station of his own free will.
He wants a solicitor. Philip, tell them you want a solicitor. Don't say anything without one.
He's not under arrest. He's free to go at any time.
Do you recognise these, Philip? For the benefit of the tape, I'm showing Mr. Austin exhibit RC1.
They're my mum's tablets.
And can you tell me why it says carbamazepine on the label?
and the contents have been identified as aspirin.
No.
You told Sergeant Cryer you hadn't seen your mother for several months, is that right?
Yes.
Your old mum was a dab hand with a mop and bucket, wasn't she? In fact, she was almost obsessed with cleanliness.
She's not obsessed, no.
But it would surprise you if we found your fingerprint on the bath panel, wouldn't it? Because Marie was out every day with the bleach and an old rag.
I told you, I haven't been to my mum for ages.
So whose fingerprints are they?
My mother died of natural causes. She had a fit. She drowned in the bath. Why can't you just leave me to grieve in peace?
Did you have an argument?
No.
She never really liked Sandra, did she?
We just keep Sandra out, Ellis.
Wasn't good enough for her little boy, right?
Sandra's my wife.
Marie was your mother.
Madam. You can't park there.
Why not?
Security. You'll find parking over there.
Oh, right. You're sick though, Sarge. We do all the work and DS Beach, you couldn't give a monkey, he's gonna take all the credit.
It's a job, isn't it?
But he won't even listen to you.
I'm uniform, aren't I? Why would he want to listen to me? Mrs. Austin, what can we do for you?
As if it isn't bad enough that we've got a bereavement on our hands, you come along and accuse my Philip of being responsible for it.
No, he's not under arrest, he's just helping us with our inquiries.
What inquiries? It was suicide.
Debbie, will you do me a favour and get a cup of coffee for Mrs. Austin, please? Mrs. Austin, would you like to come this way?
Yes, Sarge.
Oh, Debbie.
What do you want, Reg?
There's a car parked out the front. I wondered if it had anything to do with your suspicious death.
What car?
No, it's a blue Fiesta. I looked it up in my book. It was parked in Harless Row, first day of the crackdown.
You grew up with epilepsy, didn't you? Having a mum who was epileptic couldn't have been much fun, could it? What happened, Philip? Did she fall on the floor, froth at the mouth? Did the other kids all stare? Were they frightened? Did they tease you? You were embarrassed by her, weren't you?
Sometimes.
But she was all you had. The other kids didn't want to know in case you were touched, right? She was the only one who cared. Until Sandra came along.
She loved me.
When did you last see her, Philip?
I told you.
3 days ago? 2 days?
Was she alive or dead?
Months.
So why was a hire van, which you were driving, parked no more than a couple of yards away from her house?
What if I want to go now?
You can always change your mind about a solicitor.
Vehicle's not lost or stolen. Last known keeper, Miss Sandra Matkins.
That's it?
What?
The Matkins girl. Matkins is Sandra's maiden name.
Philip is not a murderer.
Sandra, if you know anything at all, you should tell us.
I'll tell you. She couldn't stand the thought of anyone taking her precious little son away from her. That's why she hated me so much. I gave him independence. Gave him love. He didn't need her anymore.
And she resented that?
Of course she did. He was her little boy. Her little darling. You know, she even called me a slut to my face.
So where was Philip in the middle of all this?
On his head as usual, hoping that it would all go away. Or that by some miracle, me and his mum would get on. Get on? I'd never even been to the house.
How do you explain the van?
She was so lovely.
Philip, how do you explain the van?
I can't.
How do you explain the aspirin?
Perhaps she mixed them up.
I've been to the house. I've seen it. Your mother had labels for everything, Philip. She had 6 different kinds of sugar. People like that do not confuse aspirin with carbamazepine. Especially if their life depends on it.
Why did you do it?
I love my mum.
Why did you lie to Sergeant Cryer?
I didn't.
You're lying to us now, Philip. We know you were there.
I think I'd like a solicitor now.
What was that?
I want a solicitor.
Sandra's car was there the day before the hire van.
According to Sandra, she hasn't even been near the house.
And now Philip Austin's asking to see a solicitor.
Well, if they're in it, they're in it together.
What is it? What's happening?
Philip's called for a solicitor.
Good. They'll probably sue you all for wrongful arrest.
Mm-hmm. Sandra, when did you last see Marie?
Sorry?
You said that she insulted you to your face.
Did I?
When did you last see her? Well, you must remember it. It would stick in your mind. You didn't go to her place. So where was it? Did she come to you?
You must be joking.
Does Philip ever drive your car?
My car? I wouldn't let him drive my car.
Are you sure about that?
He's not insured.
You went to see Marie, didn't you?
No.
Your car was seen outside the house 3 days ago, and Philip's van the day after. Come on, Sandra, Philip's putting everything on the line for you. You went to see Marie, didn't you? It's stuck in your throat to do it, but you did, didn't you? Why?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What pushed you? What took you to the edge?
I found out he was seeing her behind my back.
So you went to have words?
You've no idea what it was like. Everything I did, she did better. I never made his gravy right, I ironed his shirts wrong. It was like she was his mistress and I was just his wife. I felt that small. I put my foot down. He had to stop seeing her.
But he didn't, did he?
No, he didn't.
How do you think Philip's going to cope with prison?
Don't, please.
It must be in hell for him, finding his mother in the bath like that. You've driven a wedge between you. How did you cope with telling him?
I told him I'd been to see her.
And?
I told Marie that he was my husband now, that we were having a baby, that now it was my family. She didn't like it. She called me a slut. Me a slut? She wasn't even married. Where was Philip's father in all this? That's what I want to know.
Sandra, just think of Philip now.
As soon as I had the chance, I took it.
You swapped the drugs?
She went upstairs to the bathroom. I had these aspirin on me. I knew how important the epilepsy drugs were. I wanted to get her back. I wanted to hit her where it hurt.
You realise what could happen?
Yes. I hope she'd fall down in the street and be crushed by a juggernaut. Or have a fit at the railway station and fall onto the live rail. I hated her. Just wanted her out of my life. Later I told Philip. He went round there and found her in the bath. Tidied up. He even put the soap dish back. Nearly killed him. She still won. Because that's it now, isn't it? That's it.
Oh, hello, Reg. What you got this time?
Would you excuse me for a moment?
That is the duty of solicitor.
What's he done?
Probably charged too much to his expense account.
Yeah, we're not now, Inez. Just nicked a woman for murder.
How many points is that worth?
Oh, sir. Solicitor, Mr. Austin.
Right, this way, please.
What will Philip do with that, his mum or Sandra?
Oh, well, I guess he'll have to learn to fend for himself, won't he? Who won the bet, Reg?
Oh, sir, sure. Nick and I decided to call it a draw.
Nice one, Bob. Good result all round, eh?
Is it?